data and see how it looks. Another thing that I printed is a mod for my fan. So I printed out the parts for the Hydra or Hydra, I don't know how to pronounce it, fan duct. So we upgrade from one part cooling fan to two part cooling fans. Here we also use the three nuts and bolts. And as you can see here, we got a little bit of stringing with my printed parts, but that's not an issue. And in this holes, we have to fit in the M3 nuts. So let's try if they fit in. It's a tight fit, like with the case, but with a little bit of force and love, we get it in just like this. And yeah, I will assemble this now like it's described in the instructions and let you watch my assembling process, because there's not much to tell you about. I will tell if I get any problems, but I hope there won't be any problems, because this seems well designed and this instruction is pretty long, so there shouldn't be any issues. So after assembling nuts or inserting the nuts, we have to disassemble the old fan duct, hot end, etc. So let's do this and then go on to the next step. So now we disassembled the fans and only the hot end is left on the mount plate. We will also disassemble the hot end because I also got a new one. I will show later in the video. It's an upgraded version. I don't know yet what the upgraded parts is, but we will take a closer look in the next part of the video. So we will go on with taking the mount plate apart. So because we are changing the hot end, I'm just cutting this off because it won't come out as I thought it would, and we are done. So next step, reduce the dust a bit. So we got a little play in the plate, but I think it's still okay. Nothing to be worried about. So this part needs to go back here. For this, we have to loosen this upper two bolts, and then we should be able to just slide it in like this. So these are M5 bolts, so We need an 8 millimeter wrench, and they are not pretty tight, so it's pretty easy disassembling them. So, as you can see, there are only four parts, and these spaces here, we need to insert them into the part I've shown before. They go in here, and like the nuts before, we need a little bit of force to put them in. I will do it with a vise so everything goes in straight. But first, let's disassemble the second one. Second one is also no problem. So this is what it looks like when it's pressed into it. This went in very easy with the vise, so let's assemble it back together. Just slide this over, lines up perfect as you can see, and put all parts together. So now let's tighten this up. Not too much, because these are self-locking nuts, so no worries that they will get loose again. Just tighten it a bit up until there's no play left. Now is that we got a lot of play, different than we disassembled it, so now we have to find out why. Because everything is back on here, so there's nothing that's really different, but it just might be that there's play in the hole and we have to press it down before we tighten it up. So as you can see, lots of play now, but I tighten it up again and we'll hope for the best. So after tightening it up, it got better, but still not like I wanted it to. So as you can see, still lots of play here. So one problem could be that this one is not laying deep enough on the plate, so I might disassemble it again. And press it on a bit more As you can see, we got some millimeters. Maybe you won't see, but I can see we can get about 1 to 2 millimeters more down here. So that will take out the play, I hope. So now I disassembled it again, and I recognized that the spacers I showed you before weren't pressed in enough, so I repressed it, and now there's no more play. This is just the flexibility of the material. And now we will go on in the assembly. So in the next step, we will mount the new hot end I got here. I bought it on AliExpress. It is an upgraded version. I don't know yet what are the upgraded parts. As far as I can say, this is now round, the cooling part, and not square as before. Here you can see them in comparison. So you can see it got a bit taller, so we will have to do our offset again after installing, but that is something we have to do all the time. We disassemble it, and yeah, the cooling part is bigger, so this might be better. It came pre-assembled, so I will install it now and see if it works out of the box or if I have to assemble something again. One thing I can say is we got this little hole here. This screw is not included in the new hot end, so I might put this screw in, but I think it's not really necessary because this is just a tube slided in and pressed down by the screw. And this one is a thread inside, so it's threaded in. So no need to do this. Also, the heat block is bolted on to the heat sink here, and here it's just screwed on and blocked by tightening the nozzle. So we will see if this fits in here as I planned. This now is that we need new M3 bolts because the old ones are too short for this new hot end. So let's hope that the ones I got will fit in. Okay, so the first ones I got are much too long, and I think the other ones I got are way too short, so we might have to cut them a bit shorter because as I mentioned, I do not have anything between these two lengths. So I will cut off two and then we will go on. So this is what it looks now with the assembled hot end, and I think it looks pretty nice. And now we have to prepare the side mount to get installed. This is the side mount, and then we will see how we go on and how everything works out. So I did some cable management and plugged in all the cables of the new hot end and also of the new fans. This is just plug and play, so nothing interesting. Only some connectors weren't fitting into each other, so I had to solder some other connectors to it, but that's nothing much to do. But some connectors wouldn't fit, so I had to solder other connectors to it, but it wasn't a lot of
extra work, so I didn't film it. So in the next step, we put on the side mount. This is secured by just two screws, one in the upper left corner and one in the bottom center. Screws in very nice and easy. And now the second screw to get this aligned right. So despite I feared that this would be too long, it's just going into the profile but not scratching anywhere, so we can keep it that long and don't have to worry about it. So tighten up all other screws, not like that, a little bit less because we hear it already cracking. That's not what we want, but it's still stable. So, no worries. In the next step, we're gonna install the hot end fan like this. These are self-tapping holes, or we have to thread in the screw just into the hole. So, I will do this with every hole once before I screw on the fan. So it goes easy and I can see if I'm in the middle of the hole. So there's no need to screw it in the whole length of the screw because we have to mount the fan. So if you go in just 5 millimeters, I think this will be enough. The hardest part is to get the screw right in and not in an angle so that we are destroying our parts here. So that's the only thing you have to pay attention to, I think. As you can see, this part is very flexible in here, so be gentle, not use too much force because otherwise it could break off and you have to print it again and also disassemble this whole thing again. Also, when you install your parts, you have to pay attention where your cables are going, so try to get them all aligned together so that they won't get caught in any moving parts. So I'm gonna take this back here and like this, so that it gets in from down here. This looks pretty good and now just screw it on. Now we are almost done. We have now to install the part cooling fans. Just insert the printed parts here. And with these two screws we can secure the height. So we need to get the right height to cool the nozzle. And I think this might take a moment. And you have to guess in the first moment. So I think this will be a trial and error procedure. So nothing to worry about, just watch out that the air vents are not touching the build plate and everything else should just be fine. So this is secured very tight. And now the second side. maybe it's easier to put in the fans first and then install everything together. So I will disassemble it again and put the fans in first so that nothing breaks, because I'm afraid of that, because you hear some cracking noises sometimes, because I might not be gentle enough for the PETG material. It's a pretty tight fit, but I think we'll get it working. So as you can see, we lined up pretty good and now have only to put in a screw. There's a pretty big gap around here. I'm not sure if my part didn't print right. I'll take off the other side and we'll compare. But I thought my printed parts will be okay. So let's find out. Just slide it out. This looks pretty much the same. So let's put a fan in here and see what it looks like. Curing both bolts. It now looks better, still a little gap, but I think it will work just fine. And if there are any problems, I will glue the gap and then it's also solved. So let's put them in place. Also think about where you want your cables to go. So I want my cables to go right behind here. Okay, that's a bit tight. Not to say too tight. So let's get this to work. It's really tight, so maybe you should do this earlier. But with some little effort, we get it to work. So now, so before you do these tasks, always think about if you got the right one in your hands, or you will do it again, but as you say, the second times it gets easier. So also my screws are a bit too long, as you can see here, so we will try first if we get this working here, and it won't work, so I will cut off the screws right above the nut, so we don't get problems there. So that's what it looks like now. Not a beauty, but it will do the job. So as I mentioned earlier, just watch out that the fan duct won't touch your build plate, and I think the rest is trial and error, so I think it could be pretty hard to get it right the first time. So, and again, put the cable through here. Try to not get annoyed by it, because you're doing the third time. But as you can see, with a little effort, we get it working. Pull your cable through, and like the other side, assume your height. And then tighten your screws to hold it in place. So this is what it looks now. I think this looks pretty nice and it could work out like this. One last step we need to do is to install back the BL Touch, but unfortunately I forgot to print the holder out. So I printed out the parts and now I am able to install them. The first thing we need to install is this top plate, like this. So now you can see it. Just screw it in. Also, we got one screw, we have to screw in from the back. And I did not print out the original BL Touch mount because then I would have to print again this fender, because you insert a nut from the inside and then mount the plate to it. So to save some time and printing, I found this remix online on Thingiverse. This mounts like this up here and you can install the BL Touch up here. So because this hot end is pretty long, we have to look if our BL Touch is long enough. So just hold it onto and I would say this is not long enough, because when the pin is not deployed, we are right at the height of the heat block. So we have to put some spacers in between there. Maybe I just figure something out that will fit there. So maybe I find some old print that fits in there and I can drill two holes in it to make it a spacer. So I found this old PLA print. I just had to cut it to the right size because it has holes in the right distance already printed out. So this gets down to here. It's not that pretty now, but I think if the printer works again, I will do a custom mount to mount down here and mount it upwards. This looks about a bit too short still. So I got, for good luck, I got two of these parts. So we will have to use both and get it mounted. And like this, we can put the screws through here. They are pretty long. Let's see if the short ones will be long enough. But as you can imagine, they are not. So we will keep this for the first time to get it printing again. So I've got all things installed. Started up the printer. And here's the first test of the fans, turning it up to 100%. And as you can see, they are making a lot of noise, and if you put your hand down beneath here, you can make you can feel that they are moving a lot of air, and I think this will work just fine. So I will assemble the rest and then we will start printing. So here you can see the final setup with my new printed BL touch mount right in front of the fan for the hot end cooling. It prints pretty well. With this setup I printed one Benji. I will show you some seconds. So the setup here is done as far as I can say, but as you can see we have some work left to get done, but this will be covered in another video. So now to my Benji I printed out. This looks pretty good. Came out very nice, but we have some little blobs on the outside and also some minor stringing right in the door. But also this will be covered in another video how we can get rid of this. At least I hope we can get rid of this, but I achieved better quality before, so it shouldn't be a problem now. So if you liked the video, consider to subscribe to my channel and leave a like, and see you next video. Bye.